We do keep up with Tenley and Kiptin from the Bachelor Pad, and today they're going to be showing us something that you probably, as a chef, would enjoy. It's a gluten-free twist on a traditional pizza. Take a look.
I'm with one of my very favorite TV couples, Kiptyn and Tenley from the Bachelor series. And we're in the kitchen today because Tenley is launching a gluten-free website and she's gonna show us how to cook gluten-free. Tell us about your website.
It's called sweetandfreelife.com and it is about a gluten-free and healthy and active lifestyle.
Do you guys cook together?
Yes, actually, funny story. One of the first things that I admired and crushed on Kiptyn about was is all about his cooking, and he made me eggs one late night. It was
really no Taco Bell
I've ever had.
I've always loved cooking. Really, I love eating, and so cooking was by necessity. But you know, you can control what you put in it. I believe in having a healthy lifestyle too, and so it's always been a passion of mine. And actually, since Tenley and I have gotten together in the last year and a half, 2 years, we start cooking together all the time.
So you guys create some of the gluten-free recipes together even?
Yeah.
Now, when you were on the Bachelor and Bachelor Pad, did you guys have to do your own cooking? How did you eat during the day?
It's a combination. We do cook for ourselves in the house, but when you're out on these dates, a lot of times, you have these amazing meals in front of you, and you can't eat them because you're in conversation, so you end up eating either before or after. So a lot of that actually goes to waste.
I was wondering how the food always tastes so beautiful. So what are we cooking today?
Today we're going to make pizzas using portobello mushroom caps.
So this is the crust?
Yes, this is the crust. Wow. I know it doesn't look as pretty now, but it's gonna look beautiful right before you eat it.
You were telling me something about the pasta sauce. Pasta can have gluten sometimes?
Yeah, so we're gonna use just tomato sauce, but I bought a canned tomato sauce. I didn't make it myself, but it did clarify and say that it is gluten-free.
Now with our pizzas, how do you start the layering process?
All right, so first of all, you rinse, you wash your mushroom caps, and then you remove the stem. I already did that.
Since you're using a portobello mushroom, I'm assuming it cuts down on the cooking time because you don't have to cook raw dough. Is that correct?
Right. Absolutely. It takes about 8 to 10 to 15 minutes. 8-year range of your stove actually does matter, but mine cook really fast.
Okay, so good. So we have the pasta sauce. What comes next?
So we can go ahead and put some cheese on. Do you want to grab some cheese?
So we have our cheese, and then you have your onions and your peppers.
My family always had pizza on Friday nights, and we'd watch a movie together. But this is a fun way to do it because you get to create your pizza with your kids, unless they're really against the mushrooms and you can't trick them enough.
Okay.
But it's a great, healthy alternative.
Now, do you always follow Tenley and eat gluten-free?
Kind of by default. I mean, I never really knew much about it until we started dating, but when you eat together, you kind of have to cook together. And so by default, a lot of times I will.
What temperature would you cook these?
So place it on 350 and cook 8 to 10, maybe even 15 minutes. You just watch it closely around the 10 minute mark. Portobello mushroom pizza.
Mm. And it smells so good. Oh, I can't wait to try these.
So you heard Tenley say that about the making the food?
Yeah, I mean, a man who can cook is guys who are watching, you know, the three of you that are watching, cook for your ladies.
Exactly.
They love it.
So when you, let me ask you a personal question. When you're on a date, would you like to cook for the woman or would you prefer to go to a restaurant? Like, does it feel like work for you?
You can't pull out the heavy artillery the first night, so I don't cook the first night.
And that, he means,
that's a big commitment
and a big move. Like forks, spoons, and all that stuff, right? Yeah.
I think the first date, drinks are a good first date. Right?
Okay. Yeah,
because you want to give each other the opportunity to bail if you have
icebreaker.
To, or turn it into dinner if,
exactly.
if it's going well, right?
Well,
no one wants to be stuck at a table for hours.
That's true.
Yeah. So now, when you cook for someone, you've invited them into your home. So that's that's the next level, right?
Right.
But cooking for a person is such a maternal, nurturing instinct, and few men have those instincts.
Exactly.
So we could pretend by cooking.
Yeah. Right.
We can convince a woman that we're actually nurturing and we care about you.
Well, they look like they were having fun in the kitchen. At least they seem like they were too. So it's a good thing to see a couple cooking. But coming up next, you're gonna whip up something in the kitchen too, right? For me, because he knows I'm his TV wife.
It's gluten free too.
It's out there. It's simple.
Just on TV. Why? Why do we have to limit it to TV?
Don't tell everybody everything.